Hi students, good morning. So this session we will solve the problems on balance sheet. So here the question was, from the following trial balance, they given trial balance. So what we need to prepare here, by the way, using these trial balance, we need to prepare balance sheet of Star Company Limited as at 31st March 2018. So here, in this trial balance, whatever the information they given, all the information, it is related to balance sheet, right? So whether it may be whatever the information it is useful to preparation of the balance sheet, that useful information we need to select here. So this information, as per the Schedule 3 of Companies Act 2013. So here the information, the first one here, equity share capital. So compared to previous question, so in this question they give us some little bit point by way of trial balance. So first of all, in the trial balance means there are four columns, right? Serial number, particulars, debit and credit column. So in the debit column, what are the various transactions we can record here means we can record all the assets as well as expenses in the business organization. And in the credit side, we can record all the liabilities as well as capitals, including incomes, whatever the incomes in the business, all such transactions we can record in the trial balance credit side. So come to the first transaction here, equity share capital, they given 2 lakhs. This is what related to capital transactions, right? On the same day, preference share capital, they given 3 lakhs, reserves and surplus 3 lakhs. And sales totally 5 lakhs rupees, non-current liabilities 2 lakhs. So these are the few transactions they given in the credit side of this trial balance. And the same being, the next transaction, tangible assets 4 lakhs, intangible assets 2,50,000 rupees, and salaries 30,000, printing and stationery again 30,000, rent 80,000, purchases 3 lakhs, and trade receivables 3,50,000 rupees. So in the both columns, the total balance 15 lakhs debit as well as credit side. So this is what given information for that preparation of balance sheet of Star Company. Now we need to apply the format for that preparation of balance sheet. So here the first one, we need to take headline, balance sheet of Star Company Limited. Balance sheet of Star Company Limited as in 31st March 2018, in this date we need to prepare balance sheet. Normally, the books of accounts are closed on 31st March of every year. So, on that date we need to prepare all the financial statements, whether it may be either profit and loss account or balance sheet or cash flow statement. All these statements we can prepare in this particular date only. So, by the way, preparation of this vertical balance sheet, we require 3 necessary columns. The first column regarding particulars, second column for note, and third column for amount. So in that second column, note column, so whatever the small calculations, all the calculations we need to take separately. So here in the balance sheet, particulars, note number and amount, you have applied the format, and under the particulars, the first headline, equity and liabilities. Equity means nothing but capital and liabilities. Under the equity and liabilities, we have 3 appropriate heads, right? So in that 3 appropriate heads, the first one, shareholder funds. The first head is shareholder funds. So under the shareholder funds, what are the various necessary transactions we need to record? Means here some information regarding share capital. So here the first information, equity share capital 2 lakhs as well as preference share capital 2 lakhs. Both are related to share capital, right? They given 2 transactions. For this 2 transactions, now we need to apply 1 working note. The working note here, notes to accounts, note number 1, share capital. Now we need to find this share capital amount. So in this share capital, equity, so I have to apply the format, particulars and amount column. So under that, we are finding share capital, right? So in the share capital, the first one, equity share capital 2 lakhs rupees and preference share capital 3 lakhs. Both are related to total capital balances. So now we have to make total 2 lakhs plus 3 lakhs, 5 lakh rupees. These 5 lakh rupees we can consider as a total share capital in the business organization. So in this working note number 1, we need to apply here under the shareholder first, the first one share capital. Here in this share capital 5 lakhs rupees we are asserting. In this 5 lakhs rupees including both the equity share capital as well as preference share capital. In this note number 1 we have to write 1. Why? Because so in this note number 1 it shows the complete and detailed information about these transactions including in the working notes. So this is what first transaction under the shareholder funds. Under the shareholder funds, the next transactions we need to follow here. The next one, reserves and surplus. Reserves and surplus, they give 3 lakhs rupees, right? Reserves and surplus. In this reserves and surplus including profit and loss account for the previous years as well as whatever the reserves in the business, all such transactions we can record here itself only. But one thing here, so in this question they given few incomes as well as expenses. When we are preparing balance sheet, no need to record that incomes and expenses, but now we need to ascertain whether it may be either profit or loss in the business organization. Suppose when there is a profit means on such situation we need to record that, we need to add this profit in that reserves and surplus account. So now we can apply the working note number 2. Why? Because they give us total incomes as well as few of the expenses, right? So we have to follow the second one, note number 2. So in that note number 2, what we need to ascertain? Here we need to ascertain statement of profit and loss account. We need to find this value. So as per the given information, they given sales. What is the total sales? 5 lakhs rupees. So these 5 lakhs rupees we can call as revenue from sales. Revenue from sales, or it is also called as revenue from operations or revenue from various activity. So we can call different names. So here revenue from sales total 5 lakhs rupees. So here as per the given information, there is only one transactions are related to income. So these total incomes we can consider as total revenues in the business organization. These revenues we can take as A value. So under that, the second step, expenses. For that related to expenses, they given few transactions, right? So here tangible assets no need to record, intangible no need to record. Again here they given some purchases. Here purchases 3 lakhs rupees, right? Purchase means purchase of raw materials. This is what expenses to the business. So we need to purchase 3 lakhs rupees. This is what expenses to business. Second one, again here salaries given, right? These are salaries. First of all, salaries, this is what expenses to the business organization. In that business organization, they are paid, by the way, employee benefit expenses. The second one, employee benefit expenses 90,000 rupees. So salaries means we can take as employee benefit expenses. This is what related to employees, right? That's why we can record these word. The next one, again there is a printing and stationery as well as rent. Both are related to expenses. So for these two transactions, now we will take only one statement, that is an other expenses. So in that other expenses including printing and stationery as well as rent totally. So here 80,000 rupees plus 30,000 totally 110,000 rupees. These 110,000 rupees, this is what other expenses in the business organization. So as per the given information, we have recorded in this statement all the expenses as well as incomes. Now we need to make total balance of expenses. 3 lakh plus 90,000, 3,90,000 plus 1,10,000, total 5 lakhs rupees. So these 5 lakhs rupees we can call as a total expenses in the business. These total expenses we can call as B. A is total revenues or total incomes, B is total expenses. So now we need to find the profit before tax, right? For the ascertaining profit before tax, we can use total expenses. I mean total incomes minus total expenses, right? A minus B. So A value total 5 lakhs rupees here. A value
total 5 lakhs. The value total 5 lakhs. 5 lakhs minus 5 lakhs, nil balance. There is no profit or loss in the business organization. In this situation, no need to carry forward these profit or loss into these reserves and surplus account. So here, as per the given information, they given reserves and surplus value 3 lakhs rupees. These 3 lakhs rupees directly we can record in the amount column. So for that shareholder funds, we have two transactions. First one, share capital. For this share capital, we are applied one working note. And for that second transaction, reserves and surplus, there is a working note, but there is no profit or loss in the business. That's why no need to carry forward these balance into these reserves. So here, as per the given information, directly 3 lakhs rupees, now we can record in the amount column. These are the two transactions related to shareholder funds. So totally 5 lakhs plus 3 lakhs, totally 8 lakhs rupees. This is what called as the total shareholder funds in the business organization. The next second headline under the equity and liabilities, non-current liabilities. Here, under the non-current liabilities, they get only one transaction. Other non-current liabilities. Other non-current liabilities means nothing but other long-term liability. So here, other long-term liabilities means nothing but other non-current liability, right? So totally 2 lakhs rupees we can record 2 lakhs. These 2 lakhs rupees, whether it may be either long-term loans in the financial institutions or banks. For this transactions, we are recorded under the non-current liabilities. The next one, current liabilities. As per the given information, no transactions are related to current liabilities. I mean, we can record nil here. So, as per the given information, we have recorded all the necessary transactions are related to equity and liabilities. Now, we have to make total balance of equity and liabilities. So, here the total balance. 5 lakhs plus 3 lakhs, 8 lakhs rupees. Again, 2 lakhs, 8 plus 2, 10 lakhs. These 10 lakh rupees we can call as total equity and liabilities. So, as per the balance sheet, now we have completed one step. The next step is related to assets. So, here the second headline here, assets. First of all, the assets broadly we can classify into two categories, namely non-current assets and current assets. The first one, non-current assets. Again, under that non-current assets, we have fixed assets. I have to apply fixed assets. So, in that fixed assets, we have two types of assets, tangible assets and intangible assets. Tangible assets means easily transferable assets from person to person. On the same thing, intangible assets means we can't be able to transferable from person to another person. Already we know the examples like a goodwill, trademarks, all these things. So as per the given information, they given tangible assets directly, they given 4 lakhs rupees. 4 lakhs rupees they are recorded. On the same way, intangible assets are 2,50,000. So both the tangible as well as intangible assets directly they are given in the question. That's why directly we can record. Suppose when they are not given directly, tangible assets as well as intangible assets, means on that situation we need to take working notes for the ascertaining total tangible as well as intangible assets. The next one, so here tangible as well as intangible, only two transactions are related to these non-current assets. The next second step, it is the second type of asset, current assets. Under the current assets, directly they given only one transaction, that is trade receivables. So in this trade receivables, including total debtors as well as bills receivables in the business organization. Suppose in the question, they given debtors value as well as bills receivables means on that situation, we need to apply working note by the way of trade receivables. But as per this question, no need to take working notes. Why? Because directly they given trade receivables balance 350,000 rupees, right? So these 350,000 rupees, this is what total current assets in the business. So as per the given information in the question, we are completed all the necessary transactions. So all the necessary transactions means here share capital we are completed, preference share capital also completed, reserves and surplus finish, sales also we are taken in the working note statements. The next one, other non-current liability completed, tangible as well as intangible assets we are recorded under the non-current assets as fixed assets. Again, salaries, printing and stationery, rent as well as purchases, all these transactions we are recorded in the expenses. By the way, preparation of this statement of profit and loss account. So in this statement of profit and loss account, there is no profit or loss. Suppose, is there any profit or loss in the business and the situation, these profit or loss we can transfer in the reserves and surplus balance. Finally, trade receivables directly they give 350,000 rupees. These 350,000 already we are recorded in the current assets. So these are the information, whatever the information they given in the question, all the transactions we are recorded by the preparation of this balance sheet. So now we need to make total balance in the assets. 4 lakhs plus 2 lakh 50,000 plus 3 lakh 50,000, total 10 lakhs rupees. So here total equity and liabilities 10 lakhs, and the same being total assets also 10 lakhs. Always in the balance sheet means assets are equals to liabilities and capital. This is what solution regarding the question. So in the next session, we will see some more questions are related to this type of balance sheets. Thank you, students.